Hello, today I would like to show you basically what all I carry in the boat. It's a lot of equipment. I've got a 17 and a half footer, and it'll hold a lot of stuff. But anyway, to start with, always have a few bottles of water. We have the General. It's a 5-gallon pail pot. I've got the recyclable bags that many of your sporting goods stores use that for a liner. And then you can throw the stuff away. There's the pee pitcher. Don't get caught peeing over the side and fall in. A lot of people drowned every year that way. Marker buoys. The rod holders, got about 4 or 5 of those in there. Two paddles. One paddle is about worthless in a big boat, so make sure you use two. We've got our camera and a live bag. We've got lure retrievers, a couple different types and sizes. I always carry a fly swatter once in a while, you need it. Side planers, electrical cord, you want plenty of that. Also, I carry a battery charger and keep that right in there. And there, I noticed the toilet paper. Always keep 2-3 rolls of toilet paper in the boat. Various sizes of nets, and then on the back there we've got the minnow buckets, a leech bag, got a small pump with hose and a couple alligator clips. I just carry that for a spare just in case. I did have a on my old boat. When it was about 18 years old, I did have one of the lines break in the bottom to a live well, and it didn't take very long to have water in the boat, so that can come in pretty handy because you can just drop it down in the backsplash and start pumping real quick because there's batteries back there too. Life jacket. I'll go over some of the safety items through here. Got gloves, balaclava, the neck scarf type thing for sunburn. Got extra ropes of various kinds, some crab trap line there. Got the flare gun. Hope you don't ever need that. Fire extinguisher, a lamp. I carry a couple different types of lights. They always have a headlight in there as well. And then the throwable device, a small first aid kit, 2 million candle power light, and then also a hoop mosquito net. And I do put that in a plastic bag, keep that in the front end up under the console, especially if I'm going to Canada or someplace. And I've used that even a lot of times just in the window or over the back of the pickup or in the SUV. Put it clear over the top and you can sleep right in there with the windows open. It works real well. Here's some of the other safety items. Got some matches and an old 35 millimeter case there. A little metal pan to boil water. I usually take something along like some dried ramen noodles or that stroganoff mix. If you ever did get stranded out, you could have something warm to kind of get you through the night. And you could use the light to signal. Then also we've got the off and the, doesn't matter what brand, just so you got insect repellent. And then we've got the thermocells. Those work real good on the deer flies. More safety equipment. We've got the two lights, the front and the rear light. You've always got to have those. It's nice to have a little ledger along that you can write information in on a day-to-day basis, what you're catching and the like. Two blocks of oak, use them all the time on the Power Pro and the braided lines. That stuff is so strong that if you get caught with it, you're gonna cut your hand. And so you wanna have a knife close by at all times when you're fishing with that. Another few things that we've got here are the carry a pair, extra pair of sunglasses. I like to keep a scissor in there. Suntan lotion, also for on your lips, the heavier stuff in the tubes. A little bit of Benadryl in case you do get a bug bite, and some hand sanitizer. Okay, I'm gonna just keep moving back through here. Got the gloves, and two of these are the gloves that you wear for when you're catching fish. I got laced real good with a northern up in Minnesota a couple weeks ago, just barely getting my finger healed up from it. He came right up out of the water and got me, and I was in somebody